하나
So he moved to Delhi eventually, where of him came back. Long story cut short, they obviously had nothing with them. They had, a suitcase, a leather suitcase, and I think with enough money they just had a folding cot and a few utensils. I think they had one tawa to make rotis. Interesting story, isn't it? Sounds like it's just out of a book or like a Bollywood movie, doesn't it? But those two individuals are actually my parents. And they started life with absolutely nothing in Delhi. They started from scratch. In fact, to the point where they didn't even have a place to stay. My mother was in one of her shifts, because she was staying in the hospital, she had to come out and take up a house somewhere. She couldn't find a place because, at that point in time, you had children over your parents. Correct? If I'm wrong, these are that means I am correct. They say that in school also.
You need to honor your father and mother. You need to respect them. They have done too much for you. Study up, do this.
Now, I was in school, I think, and during my scripture class, I remember that and there was somebody who would come and he was sharing, and this is the scripture that he was talking. It's from a book in the Bible. It's from Ephesians. And chapter 6, verses 1, 2, and 3. But my main emphasis is on verse 2 and 3, okay? It says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. This is the best part. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you, and that you may enjoy long life on the earth. You know what was my reaction to this? I kid you not, this was my reaction. Right? Honor your father and mother, promise that it may go well with you, and that you may enjoy long life. You need to say if I obey my parents, I'm enjoying life, but it is. I'm not enjoying life. I don't like to study that. I don't want to work hard for my school. That's not called enjoyment. Is that enjoyment? Money and then, getting my education done and also feeding myself off the cannon fodder and all that. But none of that. None of that's not. I had all the video games, I had GI Joe, Dream Dozy, whatever toys I could get. I got all the toys. There was a point in time my mom still tells me that I think for 2 years in a row, every Sunday, I actually had a new set of clothes to wear. Every Sunday morning when I walked into church, I would always wear something new. And this is the olden days, we're talking about 80s. Okay, this is like a long time ago. During those days, that was definitely a very big thing. And my parents were not rich. My parents were not rich. My dad started off his business, everything from scratch. My mom was making it, and she used to work in the nights. She would stand in the operation theater for like 18 hours, 19 hours, 20 hours without any sleep, come back home, and my nickname is Sanam. Where is Sanam? Oh, he's my sister. I don't know. And I'm happily running around everywhere, going on the cycle, getting injured, all the time. Like, I would come back home every single time I would go out playing, I would injure myself and come back. So by the time I'm very blessed that I have parents, I realized that my parents gave me education. They provided for my education. They sent me to a very, very nice school. I had 3 meals a day. I had clothes to wear. I had whatever little things that a kid could actually dream of, I had all of that. Here's a very crazy statistic. There are 78 million homeless kids in India. Do you know that? They don't have parents, but they have no idea where their parents are. 78 million kids, and that's how much? Let me put that into a little bit of some perspective for you. How many of you have seen Chinnaswamy Stadium? You can fill that stadium up with 2,166 times. That entire stadium, just pack it with kids, stuff it with kids. Do that 2,166 times. That is 78 million. All of you have parents. I have parents. They did everything for me. And my parents are not perfect. I'll admit that. You know, because as a child, when I grew up, I always used to think that I wish I was born in Europe. Or, you know, what if I was a white kid? Because during my school days, people used to be calling me, Karu. But you know what? I'm still special. I know that. So right now, where you are sitting, it's not about you. It's not about the person sitting next to you. Right now, this is your time with God to make a decision that you're going to be grateful to God for your parents. At the same time, there could be others who are probably thinking this. It's a father, you do not understand the situation in my family. You're probably thinking that. You don't understand the situation in my family. Every time I go home, there is so much tension, there is so much of fighting, that I honestly don't want to stay at home. I just want to come back to school. I want to come back to boarding. You know what? I don't really have the right answer here. But I know this, that there is a God. There is Jesus. And ask Him to meet you at your place tonight. If there is something that you want a breakthrough in, or you need a miracle towards, you really want God to heal that situation in the family tonight, ask God to do it. And believe me, trust me on this one, He will come and resolve it. I guarantee you that. Go ahead and pray. Father God, we just thank you tonight, God, for who you are, for being so incredible, God. If there is anything in this world that we are absolutely grateful towards, oh God, to you, it's just the fact that we have our parents, oh God. That if we born into a family, a lot of people don't have that. And we have that privilege. We have the fact that they care for us, they love us with it, oh God. Education, food, clothing, everything that we wanted, they have provided for it, God. But I ask you, God, tonight, Father, that we would be thankful and we would be grateful for the rest of our lives. In its truest essence, God, that we would